comes a group of youngsters and, you know, we want to help you. Which was very surprising because we had major difficulty to find people to fund us in those days. So we found an avenue doing the research, and that's what we were quite successful to get from NIH funding, but it's very fascinating to me till today. You get a fund to give a person something which is dangerous, that's what we call experimental. You don't know the side effect. You get patient develop side effect, the NIH doesn't pay for it. The hospital say, he's a Medicaid, we'll take him, but if he's not, we have a problem. And they went further to allow us a certain amount of patient will be okay. After that, you need the funding. Where are you going to cut the funding? To families that we as a society neglected for years, most of them single mother, less education, as a group, minority group. We have patients sleeping in the car because they kick out from the house. And on and on and on. Here come groups say, okay, we're raising money. And then they became apologetic, which was fascinating to me. We raised only, I think the first time was $6,000 or $7,000. I would just flabbergasted, you don't know what we can do with $6,000 for those patients. We start giving them parties, for example, for birthday. They had no birthday. And then we came with a bright idea, which came from the family, giving them food in the clinic, because they sometimes don't have the food. So we gave them the food, and suddenly neighbors are coming for the food. So my nurse said, no, we cannot give them. And I said, no, no, give them the food, and give them also a small present from your $6,000. And the reason why, because the neighbor now knows that this kid of ours, he doesn't know exactly what he has, but everybody said, don't play with him. He's not playing with him because there is something in him. And that's how we develop a community to our patient. And you found as they went up, and last year, I'm still in shock. I don't believe you, by the way. Somebody told me it's $100,000. Now, I don't know if you would understand it. Suddenly you have $6,000, you tell me $100,000. I don't understand the zeros as much as I should. And suddenly you realize you can do more. So what happened with your money last year, and you were willing not to support the hospital, but to support me. And don't understand me wrong. One of the most important things that you're doing, you're building up a reserve that we're getting some of it as percentage every year. So as much as you go up, and in a short time you go to another zero, I think you're close to 750,000, and if you keep on doing what you're doing, a million will be behind you before I leave, which is 2 years from now, 3 months. But you decided, instead of getting the percentage which depends on the market, and you know how the market is doing now, you put a certain amount of money for us to really give to the patient. And the issues which we run into, and those who work with me for a while will understand it. I was telling parents 15 years ago not to do anything harsh to the kid because he probably will die before the end of elementary school. And unfortunately, I was right. Till 1998, when those wonderful drugs with multiple side effects came around, they are now living. They have a life expectancy of 30 to 40 years, at least from what we know from the adults. So if you take a kid who was born and by the age of four, infected by the age of four in 1987, 88, 60 to 80% of them died by the age of four, who now is alive and have to take medication, which costs an arm and a leg, it's about $10,000, $15,000 a year per patient in the United States, only $400 in Africa, which is fascinating by itself. What you do with it? You try to build them up. So how you build up? Whatever we give them, that you here and there are helping us, you know, if you need a little bit more to the driver because some agency decided it's not important. We have our own van to bring them in to get medication. We have the whole program. We use the money for the fund. What happened? They reached the age of 18. Now, for me, that's freedom. And that's about the time I finish high school, I wasn't that smart. No, but that's about the time you become individual. When people thank me for coming over here, I'm laughing because I'm the one who need or want to thank you for what you're doing, because what you're doing keep me young too. You know, I'm an old fart, I should go and retire, why bother? I already have my fame. No, it's seeing people like you who are willing to go out of the way and do it. And it's not common in our society. It's not. I can tell you that knocking on doors to get some fund to build some refuge for those patients, and I was kicked out. Even when the final and doctor, you know, I was just let out. But I got from executive $100, $200 just to get rid of me, of companies which are big in those days. You give the heart, you give the dedication. That's what makes us feeling better, that we have your support. And it's I think you saw it, and those of you who came to the party, you go there and say, are those kids really sick? They're running around, where's my present, where's that? And that's the beauty of it. Those are kids, and you help us to keep them kids. Yes, we give them medicine, but medicine is against childhood. The richness of everything. So, I'm thanking you personally, and I have to say all my team, although probably half of them don't know who the hell you are, but that's a different story. But what you're doing is make such a difference, not only on the monetary level, but also on the humanity level, which we slowly but surely are losing with computers and bureaucracy. So, thank you for what you're doing, and I hope you still want me next year. Thanks.